Trish, and I just wanted to talk about some of the stuff that's going on in my life. I don't like to really bog down other people in my life with stuff that's going on because I know about the stuff that's going on with them, and the last thing I want to do is burden anybody with my stuff. But I feel like this could help me with getting some things just like off my chest or whatever. And thought maybe while I eat my peanut butter and jelly sandwich, I could. I'll try this out. But yesterday, well, last night was the, I guess, kind of a Hallmark day for my husband and I. I packed our first box to move. We are buying our first home together using my VA home loan. We found an awesome house like 2 miles from our work. We work really close to each other. We work in IT. And we've always rented before we knew each other, right out of our parents' homes, we rented. And this is a huge milestone for us. Like it's a huge milestone for us. It's something I always like dreamt about, never really thinking it would happen. I always had so many obstacles that I knew I had to conquer before something like this was even possible. There's things with credit, there's things with insurance that you currently have. All different kinds of factors go into it. Your debt-to-income ratio, how long you've been working, how much money you make, how much money you have saved, what your spending habits are. Everything gets put under a microscope and they want you to hold yourself accountable for it. They want to have explanations and they don't want to hear, I don't know. Which sometimes can be difficult for me because I have a brain injury from the army and, what happened there, but that can be another video and another time if anybody ever wants to know about that. We don't have to get into it today. But I'm so excited that we found the house that we found, and I'm trying not to get emotional because it's just like I feel like I don't know if anybody out there is superstitious. I don't know if it's considered superstitious, but whenever I catch the time at 11:11, whether it's at work or home, I always make a wish. And it's like my wish is finally coming true. It's just like, oh my gosh. Like, was somebody listening, or is it something that just like happened because it's supposed to happen? I don't know. I just know like the one thing I've been wishing for as long as I can remember is finally coming true, and I'm kind of in shock. I don't know if I ever expected to get to this point. I don't know if I ever expected to survive long enough to get to this point, because I've been through some stuff. Like I said, another video. But I just like go over the video that I took, well, that someone took for me. I keep going over the videos and the photographs and the listing itself. And they had taken the listing down off of Zillow the day after they accepted, well, the offer went through and everything. So that was even more surreal. It's like nobody can go see our home anymore. Like I'm like envisioning us in the driveway together, getting a picture taken in front of our house. Like I'm already there. Like I'm already there. And this whole month is just hopefully gonna go by really fast. Because we close escrow on, well, closing is, everything is gonna be on April 6th. So it's a little bit more than a month away. It's a little bit sooner than we wanted it to be. Our lease isn't up until July 27th. And so there's gonna be some overlap. We're gonna see if we can get like a friend or someone in here if they want it and see if they can help us with like half the rent at least. But I'm so ready to start putting my money towards a house. We pay over $1,000 a month to live in this apartment. Granted, the rent here in Arizona is so much more reasonable than it is back in Pennsylvania. I used to live in a really tiny town called Dublin in Pennsylvania, and I had a one bathroom apartment. I believe it was like 800 square feet, 890 square feet, and I paid almost $1,000 a month just for the rent, and it didn't include any water or sewage. I think it included trash. Can't really remember. but it was in the middle of nowhere, didn't have any amenities. There was a washer and dryer inside, but that's just only because there wasn't any services around in that town because it's so tiny. In this apartment, we don't have laundry in the apartment, but there's laundromats around. We've been having to do that. And we have an extra bathroom and an extra bedroom that has a walk-in closet. And it's actually less, a lot less than what I paid in Dublin. A lot less. So I've been trying to get everybody I know back east who doesn't want to stay back east out here because it's just so much more reasonable. I think it's easy to find work out here. Then again, I have a bachelor's degree in cybersecurity. So does my husband. We actually met in school. So it's a little bit different for us as far as education. Because we're both working in the same field. Our jobs are really similar. He works for a bank doing IT. I work in a data center. But I think if you really put effort into it and get into the grind, anything is possible. I mean, my life completely changed after moving to Arizona, and it never would have been that way if I stayed in Pennsylvania. I'm off topic. Anyway, the house is perfect. So we went and saw it yesterday, did a video walkthrough. My friend Bree came with us and she helped me take the videos while I was writing down items that were in the house that I would like to negotiate on. They had these cool ass tables, like the coffee table and the side tables, where they looked like these giant books just stacked on each other. And they're like massive looking books. And I wanted to keep those, but they're probably going to take those with them. But we negotiated the back garden. They're going to take their patio furniture and a couple of the plants and statues, which is fine, and some sentimental pieces, but they're basically going to keep the garden as is, which is awesome because it's perfect. They're going to leave us the washer and dryer. They're going to leave us a freezer in the garage, and I think we're going to pay them like $1,000. That's it. Extra, like outside of the contract for the house. So I feel like we got really lucky with that. I need to eat some sandwich. The house is like less than a half mile from a park inside the neighborhood. So it's just a matter of not being lazy and walking down the street. For Harley. Harley is my service dog in training. Right, puppy? Would you like to come up? Come on up. She'll eventually come up. Come on. Up. 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 There you go. Lay down. She's a Rhodesian Ridgeback Labrador mix. She's pretty smart. She's super chill, which is really nice. Because we had this small dog before her named Spock. Like Spock. And he was just high-strung. Nothing like a Vulcan. None of that. But Harley's an awesome chill dog. Her best friend is our cat Mordecai. They're pretty cute together. But well, this video is kind of like me rambling at this point. But if anybody finds this video, if anybody's watching, hello. If you wanna, talk or whatever, I could post more. I mean, some people are really interested in my military story. It's short, but it's interesting. It's pretty interesting. I'm excited to start documenting this journey. I mean, we have a little bit more than a month to go, but that's not really that long when you think about it. So it's really exciting. And I'll be doing a lot of DIYs for the house too. So I might even consider making videos for those. And I have a lot of things planned that I wouldn't mind recording if other people would want to watch too. So that's it for me. If anyone's watching, hi. Feel free to subscribe or whatever it is the kids do these days. But until next time.